Uh-oh, that's really bad.
We've got 30 seconds till full signal crash.
Manual override. Pilot mode engaged.
Nice try, hero. Didn't see that coming, hero. Wherever you go,
I'll follow.
You always fall with style.
Still think I'm just a memory?
You know what to do. Now go.
You got lucky this time.
That's it. We did it.
In this tutorial, I'll show you exactly how I made this 3D animated video using the latest update from Google VEO 3. While others are building paid courses and private clubs around this tool, I'm sharing the whole process for free. So far, most VEO 3 videos are just short clips or test shots. I haven't seen any longer 2-minute animations where consistency really matters and where the creator actually explains how they made it. I'll show you how I achieved the most consistent result VEO 3 is currently capable of. And I'll also show how I finally solved one of the most frustrating problems, the subtitle glitch that ruins lip sync. And just so you don't waste your money, I bought the Ultra plan myself to test it all to see if VEO 3 really is that next level AI tool everyone's hyping. You'll get my honest opinion, what works, what doesn't, and whether it's worth the price. Also, quick update, my channel just got monetized. And in one of my next videos, I'll show you exactly how much I earned in my first month of YouTube monetization using AI-generated videos. So if you want to make your own animated videos or even grow a YouTube channel with AI, don't miss this one. And before I share my opinion on Google's new AI generator, I'd love to hear yours first. Leave a comment with your first impression of the intro scene. What did you like? What didn't? I read every comment and will try to reply to everyone. All right, let's get started. First, we need an idea for your animated story. And for that, you can use ChatGPT. In my step-by-step tutorial on how to turn text into 3D animated video, I explained in detail how to use ChatGPT to generate the right prompts and structure a full script for your AI story. That video will help you understand how to ask ChatGPT the right way, so you can build a clear, consistent narrative from the very beginning. So I won't go over the same thing again. You can quickly check out that part in my other tutorial and come right back here when you're ready. You'll find the link on the screen. I highly recommend watching it. In that video, I also show how to create a consistent main character using AI tools. But today, we're doing something slightly different. In this tutorial, we're not generating images first. We're not using Leonardo AI or any outside tools. We're going fully text to video. This way, we'll see what kind of maximum result you can get using only Google's VEO 3, with no additional editing or apps. To get started, head over to studio.google.com/flow. Once you're logged in with your Google account, you'll land on the main dashboard. Here, you'll see a carousel of your previously generated videos and a button to start a new project. Inside the editor, you'll see three main video types. Text to video. This is what we'll use in this tutorial. You just describe the scene, and it generates it from scratch. Frame to video lets you animate an uploaded image or a sequence of frames. This mode doesn't support audio at the moment. Ingredients to video, available only with the Ultra plan. This allows you to combine multiple generated frames, actions, and dialogue into one structured scene with much more control. Once your video is generated, a few extra tools become available. Add to scene lets you reuse any generated frame or click the plus on a specific moment in the timeline to extract that frame. It will be saved automatically so you can reuse it as the starting point for your next clip. Then, once you've added a frame to your scene, you will see more options. Jump to continues the animation from that specific moment. Extend adds more time to the current animation by continuing motion. There's also camera movement controls, presets like jib up, orbit left, pan right, and more. These currently work only with VO2, and they don't support audio. You also will see the model drop-down. It sometimes resets your model selection, even mid-session, so make sure to double-check before every generation. Here are the current model options. VO3 quality, the highest quality available. Let's talk about pricing. Because VO3 isn't free for long, Google AI Pro $0 for the first month includes VO3, text-to-video, frame-to-video, basic camera features, and upscaling. Google AI Ultra $124.99 for 3 months includes everything in Pro plus ingredients to video, higher monthly credit limits, and top-up credits. There are lots of tutorials out there showing how to sign up and get your first 1,000 credits for free. That's great for experimenting, but if you want to make a full short film with voice, multiple scenes, and consistency, you'll run out fast. Each VO3 quality generation costs 100 credits. But now that VO3 Fast is available, you can test ideas and it still supports audio. Quick tip. Use Flow TV for inspiration. You can click the Watch Flow TV button in the top right corner, and when you click Show Prompt, you'll get access to the full prompt behind each one. That includes action descriptions, camera movements, scene structure, all in real examples. Use it to study what works and to inspire your own ideas. It's a great way to understand how to get more cinematic, specific, and structured results. Next, let's write our first prompt together and see what happens. But before we do that, let me quickly show you one of the most important steps in the entire process: how to get the most consistent character results that the new model is currently capable of. Once you've written your story or planned out your scenes, you'll want to ask ChatGPT to describe each character in as much detail as possible. The more specific the description, the more consistent your character will appear across scenes. Personally, I like to copy each character's description into OneNote, but you can use any tool that helps you stay organized. Then, when you're ready to create a prompt for a specific scene, copy your scene description, paste the corresponding character info from OneNote, and ask ChatGPT, write a prompt adapted for Google VO3. Describe the action and location in detail. Make sure to include this character description. If your scene includes more than one character, like mine, where Sky, my main character, interacts with Finch, the bird drone, just paste in the description for both. Now, about those subtitles. In my first scene, the main character speaks, and I found a way to avoid those distracting auto-generated subtitles when using the new VO3 model. ChatGPT will often format dialogue like this. That's exactly what triggers subtitles. Instead, reformat it like this. No quotation marks, no colon, just a comma, and end with a period. It's the only method that worked consistently, at least in my case. Before generating your scene using VO3 quality, I recommend testing it first in VO2 just to check the composition, layout, and character accuracy. Keep in mind, VO2 doesn't support sound or voice, and subtitles might still appear, even with the right formatting. But since it doesn't support dialogue at all, you can simply remove the speech part from the prompt if needed. Once the visuals look right, you can switch back to VEO3 and generate the final version. Also, even with the exact same prompt, results will vary each time. Sometimes I need to run 3 to 4 generations to find the best version. Next, I'll show you exactly how to write a prompt with dialogue between characters. I followed the same steps as before. I copied the scene from ChatGPT where my main character talks to Luna, a female dog. Then I wrote, write a prompt adapted for Google VEO 3. Describe the action and location in detail. Make sure to include this character description. And I pasted the full character descriptions for both of them. If your scene includes dialogue, you must include the names of the characters in your prompt. This helps Google VEO understand who is speaking and assign the voice correctly. Once I had the final prompt, I copied it as is into the Google prompt box. Then I applied the same formatting trick I shared earlier to remove the subtitles. Replace any colon or dash after the character's name with a comma. Remove quotation marks and with a period. And now we have an animation with dialogue. And thanks to the character names, VEO knows exactly who should be speaking each line. And here is the result I got from that prompt.
Wherever you go,
I'll follow.
Once I had all the animations I was happy with, I brought them into CapCut to put everything together. I trimmed out any moments that didn't quite work, added transitions between scenes, layered in some sound effects and background music. And that's how I ended up with the intro you saw at the beginning. Now that you've seen how it was made, I'd love for you to rewatch it. This time, pay attention to the animation choices, character consistency, and sound design. Or just enjoy it again with fresh eyes and let me know in the comments what you think about the new VEO update.
Uh-oh, that's really bad.
We've got 30 seconds till full signal crash.
Manual override. Pilot mode engaged.
Nice try, hero. Didn't see that coming, hero. Wherever you go,
I'll follow. Always fall with style. Still think I'm just a memory? You know what to do. Now go.
You got lucky this time.
That's it. We did it.
So, here's my honest opinion about the new Google VEO update. Yes, they've made a huge step forward. The quality of text to video is impressive, and some results truly feel next gen. But for the price, I expected more. I still don't get exactly what I describe in the prompt. Character consistency isn't quite there yet, especially when you're trying to build a full story across scenes. And most of the tools like image to video, jump to, extend, they're not reliable enough right now. The only part that really works for me well is text to video. So if you're asking me whether I'd spend this much money on VEO 3 right now, probably not, at least not yet. But what do you think? I'd love to hear your thoughts. And as I promised, in the next video, I'll show you exactly how I created a voice for my AI avatar, one that sounds just like me. I'll also share the extra tools I used to get the best possible quality. If this video helped you out, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you won't miss what's coming next. See you soon!